Hello and welcome, my friends, to a new episode of Let's Talk Morg. My name is André Neumann, André Neumann, and I'm here in my home studio in Erfurt, Germany. And I have my guitar and some instruments, and well, it's a long waiting time since the last episode because I was very busy job-wise, and so sorry for the long wait, but I hope I can go and get back into the habit of producing a podcast or a radio show, a songwriting show every second week. But it's tough, you know, you need time to relax and concentrate on focusing on music for at least an hour. Seems reasonable, but in the real world it's a little bit difficult for me, but I try my best. So, what's about the setup? Today I have some Electron machines, I have my analog keys and my my rhythm hooked up to Ableton Live, and I've got a new accessory here in the studio. It's the Push 2. It's the new Ableton controller. They have a cool trade-in session, so you can trade in your old Push. I had the first Push 2, Push 1. And you can trade it in and send them your old Push, and they use it for community projects with young adults and children to get them into new music. So it's a pretty cool step from Ableton to do it. So I took the leap, and here's the new Push. It's beautiful. It's sort of combination of the old Push and something like Machine Studio. So they have this beautiful new LCD screen, and it's really beautiful. You have some really great new possibilities to sample, to live sample. That was the main reason I took the step and got into the new Push 2. And yeah, basically I want to jam in the next 60 minutes with you and use this new controller device from Ableton and test it for the first time in the real world. So pretty new to it, although I used the first version of the hardware. It's a little different here and there, and especially the sampling process with this device is it's, you have to get used to it. But I try my best. In addition, I got rid of my Octatrack. It was sort of a love-hate relationship. I love this device, but it also had its downsides to me. So I sent it back to the store in time with the 30 days warranty. The main reason was that it had problems to sample long samples. That was my main reason, because it's limited to 64 steps to really work with it. Otherwise, I ran into a lot of problems with automatic beat detection, and so it really was a tough decision. But I'll think it's always good to keep your setup as small as you can. Even if that's small, it's really hard to get rid of these great machines, but I did the step. So this show is called Let's Talk More Rock, so too much talking ahead here. Let's get into a jam. Let's see how something works out.
Thank you.
So here you can see on the push side, if you watch the video and not the radio show only, you can see a clip actually playing, and you see the waveform on push. It's beautiful. That was the first loop I recorded. Start tweaking the sample. I tried. First thing you do is you convert it into a simpler device. And then it gives you a new track, and there you can play back the sample in different tones, but you can also really get into mangling it. You have a new mode, it's called slicing mode. I really like it. Here it goes. Let's get the microphone a little closer. Here it goes. Turn down the sensitivity. So you can play with this guitar thing. Sort of like a synth. Also like is to reverse the samples. You can reverse it here, it's pretty cool. You can also put the repeat on. So now I have to find a way to get into the slices. That makes some sense. Thank you. Just improvising here with the samples and find a way to sort of a melody. There's a lot of to do with coincidence. Hope it's not too boring. They also have new filters. And let's put in a track. Playing back. So this is sort of a first start for some sort of thing. Let's see. Thank you. some chords that fit into this crazy sample mangle thing, and turns out A, the key is A, and I've got E and Fis. This works. Thank you.
Thank you.
Whew, that was a tough one.
But it worked out. At least.
Thank you.
This was the E-bow on the guitar.
Thank you.
you are still listening. It's really hard to listen, I guess. Really sorry.
Thank you.
tried to do some vocals, maybe here and there. This was a little percussion thing. Maybe another one. So now I arranged it a little bit in life, and now I can record something like a final
sort of track out of these bits and pieces I recorded here and there. It's always it's a road trip. If you do music and if you jam, you never know how it goes out. I know you are pretty limited to the things you can do and to the instruments you have, but the last one I said is not much of a limitation. It's also harder. The more instruments you have, the more complicated it gets. So sometimes it's easier if you have less clutter, but let's see how it works out. So here's the track. Thank you. Thanks. That was it. That was Let's Talk Borg. My name is André Neumann. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. It was a difficult show, but at least I'm back. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please comment on the YouTube channel or at the Radio Free homepage. Have fun, enjoy it, do your own music, and let me know how it's going. Thanks.